For those in the audience getting to know you for the very first time, care to share where you were born?
From Augusta, Georgia, AUGUSTAGA, that's where I'm from. You know what I'm saying? Bitch 706, you know what I'm saying? Put it on, and that's where I stay. And that's where I live, that's where I'm from. I'm going to forever put that bit on. Gang.
And does it get any more specific than that, like a particular part of that area for you?
Hell yeah, I stayed on Riceboro Road. You know, well, really Damascus Road, but like on the area of Riceboro, I'm from Forestbrook Apartments. You know that's where them apartments at, you know what I'm saying? That will raise me. That's what made me the man I am today. You know, if you know you're from Gus, you know, got down Forestbrook right there, then you drive up, son, you got Highland, drive back down, you got down Fox Den, Stowe, and all that type of shit, yeah. So, and George's Place and all that shit, hell yeah.
And what ages do you think you were raised in those apartments for specifically?
Okay, so boom, this is how it happened. From birth to like 4 to 5 months, no, I'm tripping. I think from birth to like 2 years old, I used to stay in Perry Avenue. People in Augusta, yeah, I know about Perry Avenue. Not a safe place, don't go there. That's like Ninth Ward area. Yeah, my dudes wasn't having it as much, you feel what I'm saying, you know, so I was staying out there. But so I was living with my rest in peace aunt and Kate and Aunt Susie. They both passed away. We was living in this small house, and my mom ain't had no place to stay, so we lived down at goddamn Perry Avenue, and goddamn real run down, roach infested. It was bad. And then goddamn, mom got her money up. You know what I'm saying? Got a 2-bedroom apartment with me and my older brother, Forest Brook. And we stayed there till eighth grade. Stayed there till the eighth grade. And that was also, you know, in the hood, roach infested, you know what I'm saying? Waking up, goddamn roaches in your cereal box, all type of shit. But look, though, there's no problem with that because it turned me to the man I am today. I'm a very appreciative guy, you feel me? So everybody got a story. That's my story right there. So yeah, I lived there till eighth grade.
And then do you want to share any further of that chronological order after that point?
Hell yeah, because okay, so boom, shout out to Mike. He was my stepdad at the time. He did some grown man business, you know what I'm saying? He was, you know, messing with my mother, and I commend him for that. He knew that we was staying in the hood, and he ain't like that. We got down, you know, having roaches and shit like that, and all type, couldn't afford, you know, nice apartment, stuff like that, boom, boom, boom. So, as a man, you know, he helped us get into a better place in Augusta. Some real nice apartments. I was living there for like all from eighth grade to like high school. We were still struggling though. We were struggling, like, because even though he moved us out there, most of our money was goddamn for rent. So, yeah, we were still goddamn going through it just a little bit, but yeah.
And then after that?
Then I got on my own. I had to get on play. I, you know what I'm saying? I started chipping into my own, like, you know, rent and shit like that, you know. Yeah, yeah.
What age? Go ahead.
Yeah, that's it.
What age was it when you started living on your own?
I'm not necessarily still living on my own. It's just like my situation now that I do pay, you know, rent. I don't want to get too deep into, like, the situation itself. Oh, why? Some supporters probably know why, but, you know. But yeah, I say this happened like, I'm 22 now, like 20, 21? About 2021, yeah.
And while you're on the subject of your age, care to share your birthday as well, the month and the day perhaps?
November 18, 2001. And birthday just passed. It was a decent birthday. I had that shit on. I had an old Prada because I'm proud of me. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, it's a great birthday.
Now, just to rewind here, you mentioned high school. Care to share the name of the high school at the time?
Richmond Academy. I went to Richmond Academy, Academy of Richmond. Yeah, class of 2019. Damn right.
You used the phrase roach infested.
Yeah.
Now, for those in the audience that have never experienced that, can you shed some more light on what that was like.
Bro, that shit is terrible. like, it's terrible, but it builds character. And it teach you how to be clean. Because the misconception that people have, when you have roaches in the hood, that does not mean you are dirty. My mom is one of the cleanest people in the world. Okay? It's something in between, like, the walls of the, like, what apartments be going through and shit. Like it's the maintenance itself of the apartment that, like, where the location, all that shit got something. It's not, like, the tenant fault. It can be worse when the tenant is dirty. You get what I'm saying? So, like, but you got to think about it like this, bro. Like, just imagine, like, you got company over and you got a little critter going on. Like, that shit is embarrassing. Like, it's real life embarrassing. You got a goddamn, like, get your ass on. Like, you tweaking. Like, I'm talking and you out there big crawling, bro. Like, come on, bro. But, like, my thing is, bro, I'm glad I went through that. Like, I'm glad some days I pour my box of cereal and I'm seeing little shit, you know what I'm saying? Or waking up this, that, and the third. I remember one time vividly, I swear to God, right on the Bible, I had made me a cold-ass sandwich. I left for 5 seconds to go to talk to my mom. Came back, 2 roaches on that bed. I cried. I was a little ass kid. Because I bit into it and it just, bam. But like I said, I'm glad I went through that because it taught me how to appreciate things. I'm glad I went through the struggle, basically. I'm glad I went through certain shit like that. Oh, God. I'm appreciated for a lot of stuff that I got now.
When's the last time you seen a roach in one of your residences?
It's been a long time, and I thank God for that, boy. Like, I really thank God, because, like, living in Forest, bro, it was so fucking bad. Like, it was so bad. So the fact that I ain't got to wake up, and someday I'd be lazy. May leave a little goddamn McDonald's bag or some shit like that. I ain't got to worry about no fucking critter goddamn indulging inside my, you know, my whoop-de-whoop. Like, I ain't got to worry about that. 20, that's so fucking beautiful to me, bro. Like, thank you. Like, it been a so, I can't even tell you. That's a good question, but I can't even tell you last time I seen a little roach. Shout out to the roaches, though.
And what did those roaches look like back then?
See, that's a good question. Because when I used to goddamn live with them bitches, I used to look up what, like, type. There's types of roaches. Got American roaches, got German roaches. I think it's a Chinese. I think it's like a Chinese roach that look like Chinese roaches and German roaches look exactly the same, but Chinese roaches, they fly. German roaches don't fly. I be knowing about that shit. We had a mixture. Majority of them was German roaches. I do know that. Look up German roaches. Look how they look. Little fast ass. And they look the nastiest, but they look. Oh my God. Twin. German roaches. It was German roaches, but like when the big ones come out, look up American roaches. They are big and fatty foot. When the big one, a little 7 foot Joel Embiid motherfucker pop out. American roaches, that's exactly what they were.
Now, would these roaches only come out in the dark, or when you had the lights on, they would still show up?
This is not, I swear to God, I'm not being funny when I say this. Bro, if we left as a family to go to Chuck E. Cheese and we came back to the house and we turned the fucking kitchen light, them niggas will scatter like the fucking police. Like, the police just showed up. Nigga be chilling, talking and shit, nibbling on crumbs and shit like that. We flick the light on, they get to scattering, running around and shit like that. I'm like, bro, God, that, you can't, at that point, you can't even kill them because two went that way. I swear God, I ain't trying to be funny. I'm dead ass. Like, that's exactly how I used to be. So, majority of the time, it went dark, but like, you know, sometimes you might be chilling light on, you see a little goddamn, you know, majority of time dark, but man, them niggas four, bro, they didn't give a fuck. Daytime, nighttime, light. Yeah. Oh, God.
And when it came to those roaches, when you would see one, would you always attempt to kill it, or did it ever get to a point where
that motherfucker got to go? He got to go. Like, Cause you in it a bit like you paying the bills, bro. And you already nasty there, like you a roach, bro. I'd say if you was a ladybug, twin. You not even no ladybug, bro. You were like a fucking walking, disgusting molecule, twin. You just roam around this bitch. You're embarrassing as hell. Feel me? I'm glad I was young. I was too young thinking about, God, I don't wanna think about no females coming over the house and shit like that. So I'm glad I got there when my teenage year, older year, got there trying to invite a female to my goddamn house, and then they seen a little Johnny go crawl up. Thank God, boy. What the fuck, boy? Like, whew, yeah, they got to go. Every time I see them, got to step on them. Floss water. We used to have a little, bond the house. That's what we used to call it, bond the house. Acid roach spray. Get they ass the fuck out of here, man. They got to go.
Were any roach traps effective back then?
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. We had the little black ones. Man, y'all nigga in the hood, y'all know what the fuck I'm talking about. Like, it's like a black roach trap. It got, like, poison inside the roach trap, bro. Y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. Man, we had one. I say it's like 2000, give or take, it's probably like 2011, 12. We had one. It was the best roast trap we ever had. We had that bitch sit in the corner of the kitchen. Man, in 3 days, we seen they whole fucking family in that motherfucking small ass cup, like, dead. And it was a big one, all type of shit. Oh, yeah, yeah, no problem, motherfucker. Duh. Oh, God.
And would they remain in the kitchen primarily, or?
Uh-uh. Oh. Kitchen, bathroom, bedroom, living room, they is there. Like, motherfuckers was there, cuz. Like, what the fuck? Like, they ain't give a fuck, twin. They did not care.
Not being funny here, but would you ever wake up to any?
Oh, yeah. You ain't even being funny. That's a genuine question. It's a real question. I don't even think you're being funny. Hell yeah, I would wake up to. Bro, I just seen. You know T.I.P., right? T.I. So I just seen him argue with his son, King, say, have you ever woke up with a roach on your face? And somebody back around, have you ever woke up with a roach in your ear? Thank God a roach never got in my ear, that I know of. But yes, there's been times, the fuck is, oh, you feel me? Or wake up on the wall, wake up on the bed. Like, yes, that shit. Bro, motherfucker need to realize that shit is true. Like, that shit really actually happens. Okay.
So when you see that banter between T.I. and his son talking about roaches, you could relate?
100%. That's why I be like, little bro, King. That's why I tell him, bro, like, you don't know nothing about this shit. I'm not a tough nigga. You feel me? I'm not the toughest nigga, I ain't the toughest killer, I'm not none of that, bro. Know that I glorify that. But yes, I went through something. You don't want that, bro. Like, if you had a chance to stay in a fucking mansion, take that. Like, right now, I stay in a nice place. I'm put up. I'm good. I'm not in the hood every day. I'm not doing none of that bullshit. Like, that's how you know that shit really real. Like, that's why when you look at niggas that be goddamn not from the hood or not from a certain situation, they talk like they is, and I'm like, bro, you don't want that, bro. You do not want to wake up next to roaches and shit like that, and you got to fucking spray the house down for company. You don't want that, bro. That shit is real deal. I really felt that. Like, bro, you never woke up for that. Like, you got a whole mansion. Like, chill out, bro. Not cool. Tweaking.
Now, you mentioned a few phrases here, such as the Bible, God, things of that nature.
Yeah.
Do you follow religion?
I do.
By any chance?
Yes, I do. Yes. Yes, with a heart. Yes, yes, I do. I'm a Christian. God has shown me he's real plenty of times. On a sadder note, the devil has shown me he's real. I've unfortunately had encounters with both. It's a sad situation to talk about, but my religion is real, my religion is strong, and yes, I am definitely a whole Christian.
Now, does it get any more specific under that religion for you, like a particular branch of Christianity?
Baptist. I'm Baptist. Hell yeah.
And was that how you were raised or something you chose?
See, me, it was definitely how I was raised, but I'm a free thinker. Feel me? Like, I'm a free thinker. So, if I felt like it would cap, I would have left. I would have left. I ain't gonna lie. Like, if I felt like this, like, you know, religion with this whole shit would cap, I would. Because I think to my own perspective, you feel me? Like, so, and how I see things, like, let me say this, like, we got, for our observable knowledge, I'm finna use some big words, for our observable knowledge, we are the only planet that has life, that we know. There is planets that's capable of life, but this planet itself is the only planet that we know that has life. Now, mind you, our moon that is where it's at, and our sun is where it's at. It's perfectly placed for us to be able to have, like, cause moon has something to do with tides and stuff like that. If I just saw a video, if the moon was two something closer, I think like 2 miles closer or two something closer, this whole goddamn Earth would be shattered. It'd be a lot more tsunamis, a lot of more hurricanes, a lot more volcanoes. But no, it's perfectly placed where it's at. The sun, if we were any more closer, we'd be burned. We couldn't be sustain life. If it's any more further, we'd be looking like Mars. We'd be less likely to be too cold. The stuff in our body, right? The stuff in our body, the blood that flow, our heart pounding, the reason why we have a mouth, the way that we breathe, everything is chronically perfect. To a person, to a feeling, I feel like it is a designer, something that is designed perfectly to the way how I can breathe, I can talk, how the moon is where it's at, the sun is where it's at, the oceans, the water, everything is designed perfectly so life can flourish. And with that being said, I feel like because of that, there has to be a designer, and that designer is Almighty God.
Now, was this raising as a Baptist on the mother side of your family? Yes. And if so, anybody in particular?
Yes, mother side and my pops, they Baptist too. Yeah.
You also mentioned aunt or aunts,
yeah,
plural, here in this interview as well, both on the mother side?
Yes. I got aunts on my pops side too.
But the ones you mentioned, you know, were referencing
yeah.
on the mother side of the family.
Yeah. Long live them know.
Now, you used the name Augusta. For those in the audience that aren't familiar with Augusta, Georgia, but maybe familiar with Atlanta, Georgia, how far of a drive is that?
See, me, we're going to get that bit an hour and 30. Get that bit an hour and 30. Legally, it's going to take 2 hours. So it's a 2 hour drive, but when you ride with me, we'll get in 1:30. I know exactly how to, you know, yeah. For me, 1:30, but yeah.
Now, you shared some insight already, but gonna zoom out here and ask you formally, what was that really like growing up in Augusta?
At first, it was amazing. It was all I ever knew. And then, you know what I'm saying, it wasn't a social media area, so who the fuck knows about Houston? Who the fuck knows about, like, you know about it, you know it's a thing, but you don't think it's like a reality. So it's all I ever know, like, you feel what I'm saying? Then you, as I get old, like 6, 7 years old, it's this guy named T.I. He from Atlanta, Georgia. Okay, what is Atlanta, Georgia? And you see it's, oh, he's only 2 hours away. And then you look at this big city, like, bro, that's in my state. But as I got older, I started to realize, like, bro, I'm going to keep that shit so 100. I love Augusta, but, bro, if you live here, you're going to have to get the fuck on. It's nothing here for you. A lot of crab in the bucket, you know what I'm saying? Like, I be trying to put niggas on. the love is not reciprocated. I'm trying to be that nigga that break the cycle. I'm trying. I swear to God I am. But you can't. You can give a nigga a plate of food. You can't make that nigga eat it, bro. You can cook this shit, whatever. Like, I want to be the one that break the cycle. But niggas be on their own mindset, bro. And right now, the beef in the city is crazy, bro. Like, it's just a lot of hateful shit, twin. Like, if you not, like, deemed as a popular nigga, a cool nigga, they will not fuck with you, twin. Like, so until I got my own mindset, social media started popping, I started to see what it really was, then, you know, yeah. Like, that's when I realized, hey, bro, get the fuck on, man. Not what happened.
Now, what was the bottom point for you during your upbringing in Augusta? What was your lowest point or most negative moment growing up in that area for you?
Bruh, see me, I like vouchers. Ask Nakia Morgan. Nakia Morgan's like my closest friend back in what's the name, bro? Ask Nakia Morgan. Bro, ask Sean Bradford. Ask Quotation, that's my cousin. I used to wear other people's clothes, bro. Sixth, seventh grade year, that's when it was at its hardest. But thing about it is, if y'all like my age that watching that bit, bro, 2013 was like the year you supposed to wear like Jordan, like everybody wearing Jordans and shit like that, clothes, all that, bro. So like you were a cool nigga, you had all the newest Jordans. And I was that cool, funny nigga. Like I was the class clown. But I ain't had the new Jordans. I'm like, bro, I'm missing something. Like all the girls fucking with this nigga. This nigga ain't cuter than me. Fuck. Tweaking, bro. I gotta do something. So I started like looking at niggas that got like they wear my shoe size, bro. I'm like, hey, bro. I swear to God, ask a nigga named Nook, Antonio Davis, bro. That nigga, I used to be like, hey, bro, he had some Concord 11s. Hey, bro, can I wear your Concord 11s for a week? This real genuine, this ain't even designer done, this is Joshua Tyree Ford talking to y'all niggas, bro. Like, I'm really, that was like going, goddamn, wearing other people's shoes. My partner Sean, he had it better than I did. I got down, used to go with how he used to goddamn give me an ass of his clothes, bro. Like, that would be my lowest point. And then, what makes it even worse, I was a young nigga not understanding bills and not being able to afford shit, right? So I'm going to my mom, like, mom, can you buy me this? Can you buy me this? I can't afford it. I ain't understand it at the time. That, at my grown age, now that hurt me. The fact that I was goddamn, you know, like, kept going to my mom asking, like, can you buy this? I can't afford this. I can't, you know what I'm saying? And I'm thinking, like, catching a little attitude, not understanding what the fuck going on, bro. Like, but, like I said earlier about the little Roach situation, I'm glad I went through that. Smalls, I'm glad I went through that, bro. Because, like, it built character. I'm glad I went through that, man. So now when I get certain shit, like, for instance, like, Bred 11s was my favorite shoe back in that time that I'm talking about. I got the Bred 11s now. You feel me? So when I look at them, like, even though I be hooping at them and whatever, it's like, I look at them like, damn, bro, like, yo, little self, look at you with this shoe, like, bro, you got them. You don't even really give a fuck about it. Like, What you thought was cool then ain't even that cool now, bro. Just, hell yeah.
Now, mentally, and not just with your bottom point here, but the Roach description, things of that nature that you endured.
Yeah.
At your worst times in life, worst, so on and so forth. Mentally, has this been something you sought any professional help over?
Hell no. Nah. Chin up, nigga. Fuck no. You got if your upbringing is hard and you can't afford the newest things, you remember that. Remember that. Okay, what you gonna make different? Like, it's nothing you need to talk to about. Nothing. Like, you need to. Okay, my time ain't it right now. Wait my turn, and you gonna have that shit on. Accordingly, that's all it is, bro. Like, mentally, it ain't fuck me up, like, you know, put me in depression or like that. No, hell no. It's like, you know, I know what it was then, but I know what it is now. Like, it's my time now. I can go out and buy my clothes, you feel what I'm saying? I can do this. I can be the freshest nigga now when I wasn't the freshest nigga then. And life matters now. Give a fuck what happened in middle school. Like, yeah. Like, and that's what happened. I chin up, little nigga. And now look at you. Look at me. Like, clothes. I mean.
And care to share the name of that middle school you're referencing as well?
What's up, Langford Middle School? The hell y'all been at, man? My favorite school. I like, yeah. Langford Middle School is my favorite. Fact. Langford Middle School.
There were other middle schools?
Yeah, Murphy and Glen Hills Middle and all type of shit. They wasn't fucking with us, bro. Y'all didn't cool. Y'all was not fucking with Langford. We ran y'all ass in every fucking sport.
Didn't attend any of those.
Hell no, I never would have wanted to. I probably would have made a basketball team. Jaden Hamilton, what's up, man? I used to get cut from the basketball team, she know. I used to cry when I got cut from the basketball team. That's the only thing I don't like about Langford. That's the only sour memory about Langford. Cause like, bro, what the fuck you mean you gonna cut me from the basketball team, bro? Like, cause my favorite player, Kobe. He used to look up to Kobe. Type of shit, bro. But yeah, I used to cry when they cut me from the team and shit like that. But that's the only thing. Yeah.
Never made JV, never made varsity?
I made varsity 12th grade year. I went, these niggas gonna think I'm sorry as fuck. I got cut 6th through 11th grade and I got cut again 12th grade year, but the coach ended up putting me on. So, I missed middle school ball, I missed JV, and I missed 11th grade varsity, and I ended up making the 12th grade. I ain't get to play. I ain't get in. But I love the experience, though.
No minutes on the court that season.
One time. And I sparked that bitch. Oh, God. I sparked that. Bruh. So we were going against this sorry ass team called Harlem, bro. This nigga sorry for. We blowing them bitches out by 20, bro. Bruh. We blowing them out by 20. Coach say, all right, four, get in. I say, what's that last nigga? I'm getting that bitch. I'm in that bitch. Ooh. So boom, I get in. You would think I'm nervous because I done got cut so many years back to back. Bro, I'm in that bitch, Kobe Stoneface. Nigga, this is my time, nigga. Man, look, I'm on the wing. My boy Von Trez get the ball. He's 6'7". God amongst men, nigga. I say, Trez, get to me. I'm in the corner. I'm in the wing. I'm a little deep, though. I ain't give a fuck. I said, Trez. He gave me that look. He like, yeah, it's your time. He passed that bitch to me. I line that bitch up. Man, the whole, because the crowd knew who I was, and nigga, everybody in the city knew who I was, bro. They knew my situation. They knew I was getting cut, and the city knew I finally made a team. And this is my first shot ever. Like, the city knows this. Like, so, bro, I got the clip in my phone, bro. The whole gym was loud as fuck, bro. And then, goddamn, after that, I had got the ball at the top of the key. I'm like, okay. It's damn near like a five out. When you play basketball, you know what five out is. Five out. I'm at the top. So time winded down. And I think it's going to be halftime. So I go up. Hezzy. I float that bitch. In there. That's 5 points. And then got down at the end. Yeah, 5 points. I think at the end, I had free throws. I had one free throw. And then after that, it was like a last second like layup. I pump faked his ass, got his ass jumping, laid that bitch up. So my first and last game, I had 8 points. Yeah. I was a demon at AU though. Don't get it twisted. I bust nigga ass. Them niggas in high school were just better than me.
Now on the opposite end of the spectrum, what was the top point for you during your upbringing in Augusta? What was your highest point or most positive moment growing up in that area?
The Good question, boy. Most positive from Augusta. I ain't had it yet. It's been shit that's like, I think my most positive things would be with a time when I'd be able to give back to Augusta. Because people think I already done made it now. No, the fuck I didn't. I'm not even close. Compared to what my mindset, where shit gonna be at, you feel me? I'm not even close. Like, I'm gonna get back to the city. I'm gonna have my own statue, just like how James Brown got a statue out here in Augusta. And yeah, so my proudest moment hasn't happened yet. I don't know.
Previously, also, you mentioned 3,000 likes. Care to share your social media handles?
DesignerDon_ on Instagram. DesignerDon_ on TikTok. Got 200,000 on there. Just DesignerDon_ everywhere.
Anything else you want to mention about your upbringing or question you weren't asked? People want to know about that.
I think I already covered everything. I would say some people don't realize that my pops ain't coming to my life until I was 10 years old. So before that, my mom was a single mom. And then that was my other stepdad came in like when I was like a certain age. But he had his own place. I really never had no father figure at my kid age. And my pops came to my life at 10 years old, my 10th birthday, exactly my 10th birthday. And then, you know, he gave me wisdom. He gave me a lot of wisdom. That's why I love him. That's my pops right there. He gave me, me and my pops clicked so good. Like, even though I didn't grow up, like, I never lived with him. He had his own family and stuff like that. But we clicked so well. Like, we mesh. Oh, God.
That was your first time ever seeing him?
Well, not my first time seeing him. Like, by the time I was like 0 to 10 years old, I probably saw him like, I could count on my fingers, probably on one hand how many times I saw him. But on my 10th birthday, he vowed to my mom and not necessarily me, but I could felt the presence that he gonna be here. Like, not necessarily like live with us and like be a part of it. I'm gonna know who he is. We're gonna gain a relationship. So periodically, he goddamn pick me up. You know what I'm saying? And this, that, and the third. And if it wasn't for him, my sixth grade and seventh grade experience about me like not having clothes and shit like that, it would be far more worse. Cause he knew my situation at home. So he knew my mom couldn't afford it. So sometimes he'll buy me like some expensive shoes here and there, like maybe a Christmas or some shit like that, you know, birthday, you know, bow, bow, bow. So I thank my pops for that. It would have been way worse than you know what I'm saying, huh?
How many siblings, same mother and father as you?
Oh, boy. I got one sibling on my mom's side. I got 9 on my pop's side. Pop was real bad man. Yeah, that boy used to get to it. Oh, yeah. I think he got 3 different baby mothers. Yeah, yeah.
You mentioned T.I., Young Thug, James Brown.
Uh-huh.
Do you know any of these people personally by any chance?
Hell no. We gonna know them, though. We gonna know them. Except James Brown, but, you know, we gonna know them.
And it doesn't have to be James Brown himself. It could be members of his family, things of that nature.
Yeah, because he from Augusta, so yeah, we gonna touch the bases for sure. Promise you.
Anything else in regards to your upbringing?
Speaking of T.I. was my favorite rapper growing up. If you look at old pictures of me, I had the hat to the side off the fucking ball fade and shit like that. Yeah, I want to be just like T.I. I want to meet him one day and tell him. That's it, though. Yeah.
What do you think of his current hairstyle at this point? It's not that bald fade anymore.
It's the dreads, bro. And I think he looked pretty damn good. I ain't gonna lie, looking at him, he had his little cardiac glasses. He had a dread like that, bro. He looked younger hell again. Cause I ain't gonna lie. 2 years ago, I was looking at him like, damn, that boy fell off. Cause he like when he was on ATL, he like Rashad. You know, he was on, like, he had a little skinny frame, had a little smile, like he pulled Nunu and shit like that. And my dog then, but then I was like, he had a little like a little squiggly out there on Dre. And I was like, bro, that nigga getting old. He is not who I used to, but now I fuck with the dreads on him. I'm glad I fuck with the dreads on him. Hell yeah.